I'm Joanna. I'm an editor at Pink and Blue, and I'm here with Dr. Sierra today to discuss the conceptions and misconceptions of conception. We just had a great talk, so thank you so much for that. It was very informative. We got to learn a lot of information, and we're really lucky that right now we get the opportunity to ask her a few questions. Our Facebook group has over 25,000 followers, and a hot topic is always fertility and reproduction issues. So this will be posted on our Facebook group and on our website, and I think our viewers are going to love the topic. So just to jump right into it, we basically wanted to know if there's anything, because healthy lifestyle is such a big topic and wellness, if there's anything specifically that you feel gives women a better chance of being more fertile and having an easier reproduction than not with how they would do that to a healthy lifestyle.
Lifestyle things that are important are, you know, maintaining a balanced diet, following something like the Canvas Fit Guide, making sure you have three regular meals, all four food groups, two small snacks a day, making sure you maintain your health within a normal body mass index range, regular exercise at least 3 times a week just to maintain healthy body weight as well as other measures of health and well-being. Sleep is one of those lifestyle factors we don't often think about, but just like with other health and well-being, we like to have at least 8 hours of sleep in the night to help with all kinds of metabolic and reproductive functions. Other lifestyle factors people often wonder about is, how does caffeine intake affect fertility? So having a cup of coffee isn't causing any harm, but having more than 2 cups of coffee potentially could be harmful. Alcohol intake is another often asked question. Having 1 or 2 glasses of wine with dinner on occasion while you're trying to conceive is not harmful. Having more than 5 to 7 drinks on a daily basis could decrease fertility. And we know that increased alcohol intake for both men and women can lead to decreased chances to conceive. Smoking, other toxins, decrease both fertility for men and women, so they're to be avoided.
And things like smoking and alcohol as a decrease in chances, is that just in the period of transmission, or is that like for your life? Like, if you know you want to start trying as a couple, would you stop 6 months prior, or can you stop sort of the day before?
And alcohol, you could stop probably when you're ready, or as soon as you find out you're pregnant, you should stop. But smoking actually does long-term damage to egg quality and ovarian reserve, and it could potentially age eggs faster than biology dictates they age. So there's a lot of things that determine the age and health of your ovaries. Your biologic age is the number one. Your family history, genetics is also important, but toxins that you've been exposed to, and smoking is a big one for egg quality.
Okay, thank you. That was informative. And then in terms of the most common problems that you see in fertility issues, what would those be?
The most common problems are equality and age. That's probably the most common reason we have to have these days. Beyond that, there are other gynecologic concerns, like having irregular cycles, having something called polycystic ovarian syndrome is also common. Things like structural issues, having fibroids, there's something called endometriosis that affects women's health that can also impact fertility. And then a big one is male factor. So husband's health or partner's health, well-being, sperm counts can also cause
endometriosis. Okay. And do you feel that there are some better ovulation kits and apps to be using while trying to get pregnant versus others? Yeah, they're pretty much all the same, like do the same thing.
Yeah,
okay. And lastly, in terms of miscarriages, I know that it's a common theme with migraines. Do you feel that, you know, a lot of them I know have had one and then they're very concerned about the second? What's your chances of having more than one throughout?
Having a miscarriage, your risk, general population risk is about 30%, right? Before having a heartbeat develop, there's almost a 50% chance that the embryo is not going to continue. But when you have a spontaneous miscarriage, it's very common, and typically it's not because you did or didn't do something or there's something wrong. It's just part of how inefficient we are at producing and making babies. But when we have more than two, that increase, there's an increased risk of having another. So typically, if you've had two or more losses, you need to come in and have an assessment done and make sure there's no treatable reasons.
Well, thanks very much. It's great talking to you today. And thank you to our viewers for tuning in.